Hello everybody and welcome back to the channel. I'm on my way to go get some bike parts because today we're doing a little bit of maintenance on my braking system. This video is brought to you in partnership with Red Beard Riding Academy, but more about them in the middle of the video. Let's go take it away. Okay, so we've made it back home and I'm about to get started with this brake service. I'm going to be doing the front brakes, the rear brakes. I'm going to do all the fluids. I'm going to change all the pads. I'm going to clean up the calipers quite nicely. So let's get into it. That's one caliper down, still one front to go, and the rear. Now to do the brake fluid. So here's how I'm going to do this. I turn the bars so that the reservoir is sitting level. Then I'm going to take off the cover and I'm going to fill it up to the marks indicated on the side. Check it out. When I open this cover up, I'm going to be super careful because this brake fluid is like super corrosive, right? And I don't really want to get it all over my paint and stuff. So I'm going to be very careful. I'm going to keep a rag here with me, or a lappie. As the South African people call this, a lappie. And I'm just going to keep that close by so that if there is any spillage, I can clean it up quite quickly. This normally comes with two parts. The first is this little cap. The second is this little rubber thing. You'll notice this rubber is like it protrudes quite a bit. It's actually designed like that on purpose so that as you use fluid, it closes the size of the chamber over here, basically reducing it so that it uses less volume.
Hey, editing Matt over here. I believe that is done so that there's always brake fluid available at the master cylinder so that you're not pressing air into the braking system.
So I filled up the reservoir, right? I'm going to slowly pull on the brake lever. It's very spongy at the moment because obviously I've taken all the brake fluid out. And basically what this is doing is now it's pumping fresh brake fluid into the system. I can feel it starting to get a little bit resistive, which is good. Okay, so now that it's starting to offer me quite a bit of resistance, I know that now I've got all the fluid down to the pads. It's very soft at the moment, which means I probably managed to get air in the line somehow. So I'm going to start bleeding it from the low side up to the high side to try and get all that air out the system. Okay, so what I'm going to do, you can see that the fluid is starting to slightly fill up inside of that little hose over there. The idea is basically to just pump the brake fluid so that there are no air bubbles flowing through that hose. So as long as there's no air bubbles going through there, then I know that the system is completely bled. You can see that the fluid is trying to rise up over there. There's no air bubbles coming out, so I'm pretty confident that I've managed to get all the air out of the system. And so I'm just going to close off the nipple, drain this fluid into an old bottle. Oh, I made a mess.
and try doing it without making a big mess.
Okay, now that I've bled the brakes at both calipers, I'm happy that there's no air in the system. I'm going to top off the reservoir and then close it off and move on to the back brakes. Look at that. That is not a very pretty picture. Whilst I'm busy bleeding my brakes, I would like to take a moment to tell you about Redbeard Riding Academy. If you're into motorcycles, then you're going to love what they have to offer. They offer a wide variety of services, from novice lessons and license lessons, to motorcycle maintenance, track days, wheelie school, and so much more. Whether you're just starting out or looking to take your riding to the next level, Redbeard Riding Academy is the place to go. Check out their Facebook page or find them on Instagram to learn more about their services and book your lessons today. Thanks to Redbeard Riding Academy for supporting this channel and for helping us all become better riders.
Well, seeing as I got the brake fluid out and the bleeding kit out and everything, I think I'm just going to do the same thing to my clutch because it's hydraulic. It requires fluid too. Alright everybody, well that pretty much wraps it up for this video. I really appreciate you taking the time to watch and I do hope you enjoyed it. If you did, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel so that YouTube knows that you want to see more videos like this. My name is Matt and I make motorcycle related content for you to enjoy. Remember, life is going to throw a ton at you, but whatever it does, don't look down, look ahead. And until next time, ride safe.